Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we are going to explore how to set up the Azure Virtual Desktop AVD. So I have logged into the Azure portal and let me open the Azure Virtual Desktop. Okay, so before that, we should be having the domain controller, and for testing, I have created the user account. So if I go to the virtual machines, this is the domain controller running in the North Europe location. And I have created the user account as well. So before we start, I'm going to make a changes. That is, I'm going to use this domain controller IP address as the DNS server for the VNet that I have created. So search for the VNet. Okay, this is the VNet, and expand settings. Go to the DNS server. So currently it is set to default, and I'm going to use 10.0.0.4 as the DNS server for this VNet, so that any VM deployed in this VNet will be automatically use this as the DNS server. Okay, and click on save. If you have any existing virtual machines running on this VNet, then you may have to reboot it so that it will take effect of the new DNS server that we have updated. But currently we do not have any VMs running already. So now we are going to set up the AVD with a fresh VM so that we will be join the domain using that DNS. Okay, so let me open the Azure Virtual Desktop, and here go to the host pool. Okay, now I'm going to create a new host pool. Click on create, and I'm going to create a new resource group for this AVD. And you can enter the host pool name here. So I'm going to deploy it in the North Europe location. So I'm going to naming the host pool name accordingly. Host pool -AVD. Okay, so here preferred app group type. Either you can choose desktop and remote app. So first I'm going to start with the desktop, and later we can see how we can set up the remote app. So here the host pool type, I'm going to select with the pooled. And here let's go with the default and the load balancing platform breadth first. And here maximum session limit, you can specify how many number of session user can access, and click on next for session host. So session host is where we have to create one or more identical virtual machines. We can also create it later, so let's go ahead without creating now. And once we create the host pool, then we will set up the session host. And click on next for workspace. And here register app group, no, and click on next. Click on next, review, create. Okay, so the validation passed. Let me click on create. Okay, so once the host pool created, then we will go to that and create the session host with the number of virtual machines required, and then we will test it. Okay, so the deployment is completed. Click on go to resource, And this is the host pool that we have created. Currently, as you can see, there is no virtual machines. And let me go to the Azure Virtual Desktop, click on host pool. And this is the host pool that we have created in the North Europe location. And host pool type is pooled. Okay, and let me open this and go to the settings, and under manage you can see session host. So from here we can create the session host for the number of VMs that is required. So click on add, and here as you can see these options are grayed out, so all these details are taken up from the previous host pool that we have created. So we cannot change this here, and click on next for virtual machines. So here I'm going to enter the name prefix. So North Europe AVD VM. So then the suffix will be added automatically when it is deploying the VM. For example, if I'm deploying 3 VM, then it will name it something like -0, -1 and -2. And prefix will be same for all the VM it's going to deploy. Okay, and virtual machine type Azure Virtual Machine. Okay, next, leave it with the North Europe location and no infrastructure required, and select an image. So here we are going to use the multi-session. So Windows 11 Enterprise multi-session version 22H2. Okay, and select the virtual machine size. I'll leave it with the default. And here, number of VMs, I'm going to enter 2, so that it will deploy 2 virtual machines with the name that we have provided. And OS disk type, standard SSD, default size, and virtual network. So we already have a VNet created in this resource group, so I'm going to use that. And this is the subnet in that VNet. We don't have any other subnet. We only have only one. So let me choose that. And here we need to enter the domain details so that while it deploy the virtual machine, automatically it will join to the domain. Okay, so here this is the type Active Directory. And AD domain join UPN. So here we can enter the UPN of the Active Directory that has the permission so that it will be joined to the domain. So we have created, let me go to the Active Directory. So this is the domain controller we have, acgcloud.com. And under the users, you can see there is a user called acgadmin, and it has the privilege to join to the domain as well. Okay, let me minimize this. Okay, so one thing I want to change it here, since this is the free trial, we may run into the compute issue. So I'm going to make it with a lesser size, so DS1v2, so that it will have one vCPU and 3.5 gig memory. And for Windows 11 Enterprise, the image we can go with the lightest, that is 24H2. Okay, and then we need to enter the domain UPN details here. Okay, so here I'm going to give acgadmin@acgcloud.com, and enter the password here. Confirm the password, and this is going to be the virtual machine administrator account. So we have created Azure admin and enter the password. Okay, next, review, create. Okay, so the validation has passed. Click on create. So it will take some time. It will deploy the virtual machine and then it will join to the domain. So once this task is completed, then we will go back to the virtual machine and see if the status is running fine. And then we will be going into the AVD URL from where we can access this AVD machines. Okay, let's wait for this deployment to be completed. Okay, as you can see here, the virtual machine name, the suffix added with -0, -1, because we have given two virtual machine and this is the prefix NE-AVD-VM. And the suffix will be automatically added based on the number of VMs that we provide to be created. Okay, so now the deployment is complete. If you expand the deployment details, here you can see that the VM is created and then it is joining to the domain and everything is passed. So we don't see any issues here. And if you go to the virtual machines tab, let me refresh it. And here also you can see those two virtual machines, 0 and 1, created. So these two are part of the Azure Virtual Desktop Session Host. So if I go to the AVD and under the host pool, if you open this host pool, and here under the session host, here you can see that the two virtual machine status healthy. And it's in the North Europe. Okay, so now I'm going to install the Microsoft Entra Connect so that I can sync the on-premise users to the Azure. So for that, I have installed the Entra Connect and then I'm going to launch it. So in case if you run into TLS 1.2 error, you can just follow this document and you can run this PowerShell script for TLS 1.2 and make sure you open the PowerShell with the administrator and run the script. So this is for to enable TLS 1.2, and once enabled, then this Entra Connect Sync will be opening, and here use the express settings. And here I'm going to enter the Microsoft Entra ID. Okay, and click next. And sign in with your account. Enter the password. Okay, and if you have set up the MFA, you need to approve it on your device. Okay, once approved, then it will proceed further. Okay, so this is where you need to enter your on-premise Active Directory account that has the enterprise administrator credential. acgcloud.com/acgadmin and enter the password. So So we have ACG admin account here, and I'm going to use that. That has the enterprise administrator credential and privilege. Okay. Continue without matching all the UPN. Okay, click on next. Okay, install. So here we are syncing all the Active Directory object to the Azure cloud. Okay, let's create a workspace here under the AVD workspace. Create a new workspace and choose the resource group, and this is the workspace name, North Europe AVD workspace 1. Okay, it's going to be North Europe, and click on next. Click on next and review created. Okay, so we have created the workspace. If you go to the workspace, application group. Okay, add this. Okay, so we have added the application group as well. Okay, so we are able to successfully sync on-premise objects to the Azure. As you can see, the ACG admin, this is synced from the on-premise. As you can see here, on-premise sync enabled, and this is coming from the on-premise. And then we have also created the workspace. If you go to the Azure Virtual Desktop under workspace, we have added this workspace as well. Okay, and we have provided ACG admin access to this account because we are going to access the AVD using this account. Okay, now if I go to this URL and I'm going to log in with this account, ACG admin. And once I logged in, I can see this is the workspace that we have created. Under that, there is one session desktop. If you want, you can rename as well and click on allow. And here you need to enter the on-premise username password. As you can see, it is acgcloud.com. Okay, so now we are able to successfully launch the AVD desktop that is running in Windows 11. Okay, if you go back to the Azure Virtual Desktop, and this is the host pool. Okay, so here you can see the status. There are two total virtual machines, and we can connect to two of them because both are healthy, and there is one active session, and this is the total sessions. And you can see the workspace here. And if you go to the host pool, and here we have the session host here that contains two virtual machines. And this is not connected, so we are connected to this virtual machine. As you can see, the total sessions here. And this is the application group, and this is where we set up the access. If you want to add anyone else, you can click on add and search the user account here, and then you can set up their access so that they can also access the AVD.